All right, this is old Buck, Carolina Crazy Outdoors. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Got my buddy Becca here. We're down here in Santee today. We're going to try to catch always freaking
it's beautiful.
Awesome.
Not like last time we went fishing when it was freezing cold on the last video.
Oh, I know it.
My nose started bleeding. It was so cold. Do you remember that?
I do remember that.
I took pictures with a fish, and then when I went back home, I saw it had like blood on my nose. I'm like, wow.
Yeah, it was like cold, cold. 30 mile an hour winds.
Yep. Awful.
But hey, we caught a bunch of crappies.
I was about to say we tore it up, though.
Caught a bunch of crappies.
Definitely.
Big crappies, too.
Huge.
But we ain't going out the crappies today. No. We'll be going out the catfish. And believe me, I'm no catfish expert, so.
I will say catfish is my favorite thing to fish for. I don't know why. It could be because as a child, that's what I started fishing for, is catfish with my grandfather. Absolutely love catfishing.
Oh,
love
yeah.
It. My favorite.
I mean, they're best. I think they're best eating fish.
Oh, they're awesome.
They're
fry
awesome.
Them up. Woo.
Oh, God,
yes.
Yeah.
And making me hungry.
We're going to do the video, hopefully catch some fish, but who knows. But make sure you stay tuned at the end, though, because I'm going to do a little question and answer with her. Because, I mean, let's face it, she's like a celebrity in South Carolina.
I wouldn't say all that.
Well, it's true.
No.
But so people know her, but they don't know her. So I'm going to ask a bunch of questions so you can get to know her.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I'm going to put you on the
spot.
It
better not be bad.
We'll see.
Oh, gosh, you're making me nervous. I'm starting to sweat. It's getting hot out here. I can't take it.
You got them poles ready yet?
All right. He said he's got them ready.
All right.
I'm ready to go. Let's do this.
Got my cousin in the back. He's getting the poles ready while we up here doing this. But anyway, wish us luck, and hopefully we catch something.
Ooh.
Hold on. Hold your rod up.
Come on, baby. That sounded so crunchy. Yes, buddy.
We were not prepared for this.
No, we were not prepared. You got a
hold on a minute.
Net? Or are you just gonna?
I get on my hand.
I'm gonna pick that baby up. Catfish baby. Oh, I wanna hold him.
Yeah.
Yes. Give me that. Here, let me see.
We don't use those pussy little pliers
hey!
That people hold.
Watch it. You gotta get underneath.
Don't you use that?
Huh?
Yeah.
Get it underneath it.
Yeah. Okay.
He gonna. I can't, he's all slippery.
I know one thing, he's pooping everywhere.
Is he pooping? He all pooped in my bag.
Back to what I
always hold them like this.
Back to what I was saying though.
Okay, sorry.
There's things that people got to hold them, can't hold them in the mouth because they're too sissy. We don't use those.
Let me hold that. Let me see. I always hold them underneath here.
Oh,
so
God. Don't let him shit everywhere.
He's going, I'm going to drop. There we go. There's that big baby. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, and he's pooping everywhere.
I think I got. Oh, he done got slack. Oh, he's gonna come off. You better reel up.
Oh.
Hold that rod up. He's on there.
Oh, he is on there.
Good Lord.
Oh my gosh. He feels kind of big. Oh.
He ain't a bad one.
No, he's good. You got the net. Buck, get the net. Come on.
Oh, we ain't gonna need a net for that one.
Oh, we don't need a net. Oh, he's nice. He's nice.
Good God.
Yes. Love it.
Yeah. Mash your button. You got that thing reeled all the way up to the end.
I do. I got excited.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Okay, wait a minute.
Oh, you got
to. Well, I got to show this.
Oh,
this
my
is
God.
A bad day of fishing, but a good day of fishing. Look what I just did.
See that? See that right there? He's about 2.5-3 pound catfish.
Hey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, man.
Oh, my
hey,
goodness.
I caught dinner.
God,
it's
no.
Okay.
Tell you what, these blondes these days.
Hey, wait a minute. God, I can't get in it. Oh, yes. I love that. You hear him? Ow.
Oh, yeah.
Bit me.
Okay, I got to say something.
What?
For all you guys that use these things that hold the fish, you're sissies, man. Just. Look at this. This is how you hold a fish, not with a freaking pair of pliers.
Beautiful. I hate I did that to your rod.
Oh, it gets out.
Oh, my God.
All right. So, as you can see, we only caught 2 catfish today. But, hey, that's a part of it.
Hey, it's better than nothing.
Hey, better than nothing.
Because we did have these people who came up behind us and wanted to fish right beside us.
Right beside us.
And they didn't catch anything. Thank goodness. I hate that.
Yeah, it drives me crazy.
I hate it. It's my pet peeve.
I mean, we're like on Lake Marion, and this is like a huge lake, and there's literally zero boats out here in visibility.
Just give me some space. Let me fish.
Yeah, they come within like 40 yards of us and like anchored down.
And then they said, I didn't even see you. And they still docked the
boat. I was like, what the hell, man? So, but anyway, so we're going to do a little question and answer thing because...
I'm nervous.
Are you really?
I really am.
All right. That's even
better. I'm like extremely nervous about this right now. Okay. I know how you are.
Oh, that's good.
You might have some weird questions up your sleeve.
They're not weird. They're not weird.
All right. You got me on the hot spot.
All right. How we met. People's always like, how'd you meet her?
Okay. We met at a bass fishing tournament. Which is really awesome. Where was it at? It was at the
Colonial Life Arena.
That's right.
Yep.
And that was the first time I'd ever been to a bass fishing tournament. It was really cool, though.
Yep,
and then
awesome.
We met there. And after that, you asked me to go gator hunting.
Yeah, that
was the best time. That was the first time I'd ever went gator hunting, and I was hooked. Like,
hooked. It was a blast,
after
man.
After that, completely hooked. It was like a danger, adrenaline. I mean, I've never experienced anything like that, so.
It's the best thing.
This is my... gator hunting partner.
That's it.
Right here.
That's it.
Yes.
So, where did you grow up?
I grew up in South Carolina, right there in West Columbia. Most of my family are from Leesville and some of the surrounding area. So, we used to have a land with a pond and everything, and my mom's uncles and I lived down there, my grandfather. And so, that's really how I started my love for the outdoors. So, he would take me fishing. And we would fish for carp, which is just fun. Cause I was only like 7 years old.
Yeah.
And it was fun for him to see me have to fight those fish and pull those, because carp fight like crazy.
Man.
Yeah, I mean,
they
will
big
fight.
Too.
And I'll never forget, we used to fish with like rubber worms and then like normal worms. And he smoked, so he'd look at me and say, Rebecca, get me a wubba worm and a cigarette.
That's funny.
And here we go. This is...
My dad. My dad calls me like 10 times a day.
Let's see what he's doing. Let's say hello.
Hello.
Hey, Dad.
Hey.
You catching him?
Well, me and TC and old Bowen's down here, and let's just say we ain't having too good a luck.
Nope. We caught two.
Caught two.
Any size?
Oh, about 3 pound, 4 pound.
Yeah.
Yep. Huh. All right, let me run. I'll call you back.
All right.
All right. Bye.
I like your dad. His dad's so sweet. He went crappie fishing with us last time.
Mm-hmm.
Tore us up.
Oh my God, did he ever?
He made us look bad, is what he did.
Oh man.
Always.
Always. So, you were Miss South Carolina?
I was.
How was that?
That was awesome. In 2009, I was Miss South Carolina America, and I went to the Mrs. America pageant. It was in Arizona, and it was an amazing time, like, absolutely awesome experience. I did feel a little bit, you know, out of my comfort zone because I love dressing up too, but I'm really kind of a down-to-earth girl. I want to wear camo and hunting boots. So it was really like coming out of my comfort zone with the big costume for my steak and everything, you know. But of course, my costume was a boxer, so that was like right up my alley.
Mm-hmm.
But that was an awesome experience. I wouldn't trade that for anything in the world. It was great.
That is cool, man. That's definitely
cool.
Not many people get to do nothing like that.
It was fun.
Yeah. So now you're like a model for Haybo, Yee Yee, and like what all other kind of stuff you do.
There's different companies that I'll model for. It's just a lot of fun because they sponsor me to go fishing and hunting and things like that. And I work with a lot of companies just to get their name out. And now if I don't believe in a product that I'm using, I'm not gonna advertise it. So it's gotta be something that I believe in.
Yeah.
Definitely.
That's good.
And the guys from Yee Yee are awesome. Absolutely awesome. Wonderful company. Haybo, they're wonderful. Everybody that I work with, I've just had a great experience
with
them.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Cool deal. So is it true that you're gonna be representing South Carolina in this bikini contest?
Okay, well, I am actually Mrs. Bikini South Carolina Fitness. So it's a fitness competition.
Oh, that's even better because
fitness
being you're in a fitness bikini contest means that you're definitely rocking it.
Oh my God!
I mean, anybody can get in a bikini and not look good. So being you're in the fitness part, Yes.
I've been training a long time.
Yes.
Be quiet. I've been training a long time for this. No, I'm a personal trainer also. So this is, I'm really passionate about this because I've been training hard, working hard. And it's just really neat to involve yourself in that kind of community of fitness and health. And it just that, other than the outdoors, health and fitness is a big thing for me. I absolutely love feeling good and being healthy. So this is a big deal. I love it.
I take my fitness pretty serious too.
He does. Eating Vienna sausages, those two sausage biscuits
morning. They were freaking awesome.
What'd you have, some Coke?
No, I drank water.
Well, that's a good choice.
This is a start. Definitely a start. So are you nervous?
Yes. I am scared to death.
I'll be honest with you. You couldn't melt me and pour my fat ass up on the stage.
I am
tell you that right now.
No, why wouldn't I be scared? You know, I'm going into this thing as this is just for fun. I just want to have fun. It's a new experience. It's exciting. It's going to be in Miami. I mean, who doesn't want to go to Miami and be in this awesome competition? And just enjoy. I've never been to Miami before, so that's really what I'm looking forward to, taking my kids there. And they're going to be so excited to go to Miami.
That's just cool.
That's really what it's all about. I do a lot of things for them.
She's a good mom. She's got two pretty daughters.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. I love my babies.
Yep.
They're 12 and 13 years old.
Wide open.
They are wide open.
Wide
they
open.
Grow up fast, too. Whew.
Well, I'm sure you're going to go there and kick ass in that contest.
I'll try. Yep. I'll give it my best shot. That's all that matters.
About pageants and contests, is it, like, very competitive? Are the girls, like... Is it like a family oriented, or y'all like, I hate that, I hate her?
No, actually it is family oriented.
Really?
Yes. Everybody, you kind of get to know everybody from all these states, and even after the competition's over, I have been friends with people I competed with years ago. We still keep in contact with each other. So you really do become like a family. I'm
cool.
Sure other girls have some stories and some cattiness and things like that, but my experience has been really good, like a family. I think it's a great organization to be in, different pageants and things to be a part of. So
cool. All right, hunting and fishing. So which is your favorite?
Okay, that is hard. That is so hard. During hunting season, I'm gonna say hunting is my favorite. During fishing, see, when hunting season's over, fishing is. But
I get that.
Because at the time, you know, you feel like, oh, I love this. This is great. You know, actually, I think fishing is.
Really?
Yes. I do think it's because of my grandfather, though, because that's what. Like my foundation is fishing, and I didn't start hunting until later on. I was probably 17, 18 years old when I started hunting.
Mm-hmm.
So that became like this huge new experience for me, and I was hooked, like absolutely hooked.
Mm-hmm.
But so my whole entire life I've fished, and I just love it. But you know, my hunting has become a big passion of mine.
That's good.
I mean, it's something me and my brother share mm-hmm. together, and I love that. You can't really find us at home during hunting season. We're always in the woods.
That's good.
I'm worse than a man. Like,
so off the top of your head, favorite fishing trip?
Oh gosh, you know, I went to North Carolina on a fishing trip and caught some dolphin. I thought
that was
awesome. Caught an 8-foot hammerhead.
Oh,
that
man.
Was freaking awesome. And I took my brother with me, and just the experience, like, for him to experience that, by far, that was the best fishing
awesome.
Trip ever. Yeah.
Favorite hunting trip?
Oh my goodness. I will have to say the first time I ever shot, I shot my first buck. That
mm-hmm.
was the best.
Yeah.
I had been sitting out there in those woods. It had to be for months. You know, just like, oh my gosh. I was sitting in that stand. This is probably dad again. Let's see. Is it daddy?
My brother. good God. I call him bad.
So we're sitting in the woods. I was done. I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't take anymore. I sit out here all the time. Don't see anything. But does, and
I already got on silent.
You got on silent, good. And so I kid you not, I went to stand up in the stand, and I lifted my hat, like I was just so high, I was like, oh, right time I lifted my hat up, this big old buck just turns around and looks at me, and he was like really far away. And so, I mean, he saw me, and I was mm-hmm. like, oh my gosh, I got my rifle out, and I was like, I mean, I just pretty much just, I didn't think, I just shot him.
Oh yeah.
Oh my gosh. And before I just threw the rifle down, I pretty much ran out of that deer stand. And when I got out there and saw this beautiful buck sitting there, oh my God. It was the most awesome feeling ever. You know, it was just awesome.
Oh yeah.
I get excited talking about it. Like I lose my words. Do you see me?
I killed a couple big bucks.
Yeah, but it was just your first. You can't take
it
away.
Can't beat
it's just the feeling of that first buck.
I'll be
never,
honest with
ever
you.
Forget it.
My favorite deer ain't even, you know, I got like You know, I got a bunch of deer on the wall.
Yeah.
But the favorite one out of all of them is like an 85-pound, 7-point buck I killed was my first deer. I think I was like 12 years old.
It's nothing like that first. Yeah. You're so proud of yourself.
Oh, yeah.
It's all the preparation you put into it, all the hours spent out in the woods, and, you know, it's just, there's no feeling like that.
Uh-huh.
But you can get easy.
So how's it feel hunting around a pretty, like a male-dominated, I don't know if you call it a sport, but it's, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody's been pretty respectful about me hunting and fishing. Mm-hmm. Honestly, mostly I hunt with you, and I hunt with my brother, and people that I really know and have a close relationship with, a close friendship with. I do get some, a little bit of slack from some guys don't like the fact of a girl hunting or fishing, because they think I'm trying to come in on their territory. But honestly, I was raised, you know, out in the country, you know, when I would go visit my grandfather, and that's all I know. All I know is fishing. And then my brother and introduced me to hunting, and that's all I know. So I can't change who I am.
Guys, if you think it's bad that a woman hunts or fishes, you're a dumb ass. Like, you need to get your head out of your ass, really. Okay, I had to say that.
Okay. But no, I can't change who I am.
No,
and
hell no.
That's like my roots. My roots are, there's more to hunting and fishing than killing. And it's about the time you have with, like, my brother. We bond. That's our time to bond. That's our time to have memories that we'd never get.
I know he had a health issue like last year.
Oh my goodness. So, I mean, it was absolutely scary. I thought I was going to lose him.
And I know you remember you telling me you couldn't wait to go hunting with him.
I couldn't wait to go hunting with him. We did. He was very sick, but we still went hunting. We still shot deer. And that meant so much to me to be able to share that with him after such a horrendous ordeal. When he was in ICU, he told me, and I said, you know, if you get out of this, when you get healthy enough, we are going camping. Mm-hmm. We're going to learn how to live off land. And we are going to, you know, eat worms if we have to, do whatever we have to.
Lord.
Yeah, I said this. I should not have said this, but I did say this.
And it's going to happen now.
It's going to happen. So, it's not.
I'm going to tear it now,
not
man.
Long, so we're going to trout fish. We're going to do all this. I don't know where we're going yet because he won't tell me. All he said were there's going to be bears.
Okay,
I did not say we could go live off the land with bears. I meant just teach me to live off the land. Let's go camping at Lake Murray or something.
Yeah,
no,
yeah,
mm-mm.
Yeah.
That's not where. That's
well,
not you, what's
you're
gonna
too
happen.
Close to civilization.
Yeah,
Lake
so no, we really are going camping. We're gonna go chase some waterfalls, but I mean, I can't wait. This
that's
is gonna
be
something
time.
Different for me, but I cannot wait. So he's already taught me how to get like water out of a vine and things like that to kind of prepare me.
Oh my God.
So this is like ultimate survivor.
That's funny.
Brother and sister edition.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. So one thing I think is cool as hell is we've done a lot now.
Oh yeah.
Our,
stuff all the time. It's fun.
Not one time. Matter of fact, I was the only time it happened, it was me. But not one time have you been late.
Oh,
meeting
no.
in the morning.
Absolutely not.
And I mean, we meet at
care.
5 o'clock, 6, I mean, early in the morning.
Oh, I'm going to be there.
There's only been one time somebody's been late, and it was me.
I know.
That's because I got a biscuit.
You know what I don't understand? I don't want to get up early for work, but you tell me I'm going fishing or hunting, I'm up an hour early. Like, but if it comes to work, I'm like, no, I'm
oh,
not getting
funny.
Up. Do
that's
not
good.
Get me up. Oh, my gosh. You have to, like, drag me out of bed, but hunting and fishing, I'm like, okay, I'm going to set this for 2 hours ahead. We're going to get breakfast, we're
going
to chill, and we're going to get this adventure together. I love it.
Next thing she wants to do is noodling.
Yes. Mm. I'm going to do this. I'm scared to noodle, but I'm going to do this. We're going to do this. I'm going to catch me a nice catfish. It won't be on this trip.
Nah.
No, I got to get a nice glow.
But you know
whatever.
What? I mean, look around. I mean.
This is awesome.
Those of you that's been to Santee, which is Marion and Moultrie, Santee is not a lake. Santee's a town. The lakes are Marion and Moultrie, and everybody just says Santee. Then you never know where you're going.
Yeah.
But anyway, if you've ever been on Lake Marion or Moultrie, you know that you don't hardly ever see these lakes like slick like this.
It's slick today.
I mean, freaking zero wind.
It looks like
and it's
glass.
Beautiful.
It is beautiful.
Gorgeous.
Today. We just really had a great day.
Oh, it's been fun. You got to be careful on these lakes. I'm going to tell you, these lakes will kill you. It ain't like Lake Murray. And I've seen Lake Murray get rough. But this lake here, I mean, marrying a marcher, they're so big and shallow. I mean, when it don't take a whole lot to get, you know, 6, 7, 8 foot waves. No. And I mean, it would kill you. There's people that die every single year down here drowning
really
in
dangerous
boats.
Too. There's logs everywhere.
Yeah, oh, yeah. You got to be careful.
Don't they say that there's sometimes snakes in the trees, too, that'll fall in the boats?
Yeah. She was worried about alligators out here, but I gator hunt a lot and kill a lot of gators.
He's trying to get me to jump in the water and go swimming. I'm like, no.
Now, listen, I'm
telling you. I may be crazy, but I'm not stupid.
I've been on this lake a lot now, and very rarely do you see an alligator out in the middle out here. Because we're in the middle of this lake in 6 foot of water, you know, tied up to a cypress tree. But rarely do you see an alligator out here. So
okay, if before I went gator hunting, I may would have done that. But once you gator hunt and you see that massive, what I call a dinosaur beside the boat, that's scary.
With me on a, me and my brother. And
I almost fell in the water. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
But we killed, what was it, 10 foot? 10, 11 foot?
Yeah. It was a good one.
It was
good size.
Yeah, but that was a fun trip.
Yeah, it was.
This year, I got some more people coming from out of state to hunt. I'm really excited about that.
It's going to be fun.
But I know my brother's going to be really excited, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know why.
Of course. He's going to be excited.
He's going to be like, whoa. But anyway, man, I hope y'all enjoyed this. Like, you know.
We always have a blast.
Oh, God.
Yeah, and it's cool to let you guys in on what we do and, you know, why we do what we do. You know, it's just fun.
Yep.
It's fun.
It's a good time.
Is.
If you don't hunt fish, man.
You better start.
And listen, it ain't hard to find somebody that knows how to hunt fish.
Right here. But.
I mean, I know enough to get by. How about that?
Yeah. Carolina. What is it? Carolina Outdoors.
Carolina Crazy.
We can't leave out the crazy.
That's it.
Carolina Crazy Outdoors. I'm going to tell you, this man is crazy.
This man is crazy.
Yes,
you are. Hey, there's the first boat right there.
I wonder if they're gonna pull up beside us.
Oh man, I tell you right now, I was like, good Lord of mercy.
I know, it's crazy.
I know, but anyway, we're gonna let y'all go.
Since we only caught two fish, I think we're going to get barbecue. Don't you agree?
There's a barbecue restaurant right down the road.
That's why I like coming to Santee for the barbecue.
Yep, Lone Star.
Yes.
I think it's Lone Star Barbecue. I don't think they changed the name. I know they sold it last year to another individual.
Okay, that's not preparing for that fitness competition. It's a cheat meal today.
I get
a cheat meal today. Yes. That's one of the best parts about coming here, eating the barbecue.
Oh man, good barbecue. But we're gonna let y'all go now. Got anything else you wanna say? We'll be done.
I got nothing.
I just
had an awesome day, and that's all that matters. It's been great. Now I'm gonna go eat my barbecue and take a nap. Woo!
All right, y'all. Make sure go check out Carolina Crazy Outdoors. Make sure you subscribe.
Oh, and check me out at
on
Instagram. It's Becca_Bowen_.
Yeah, you can see all her fun stuff on there.
Yeah.
Hey, she'll probably even have bikini pictures on there in a little about a month or two.
If you're lucky.
Oh, they're gonna flood it now. There's gonna be like jumping all over that.
I'm funny about all my pictures. You know how I am.
Listen, if I had a body, man, I'd be rocking it. But like I said,
you gotta keep it classy, people.
Keep
it classy, but
that's one thing I will say about you. You definitely, if you on her Instagram, she's very classy. She don't, you know. And don't get me wrong. Now, I'm not knocking girls
that
do
get
bikinis.
Your preacher can't look at it. Your daddy can't look at it. You don't need to be doing it.
Now let me tell you, these preachers, this day and time, they there's something going on up in the preacher's head now.
No, behave now. Behave,
Buck. I'm just being real. But anyway, y'all take it easy. Make sure you subscribe. Carolina Crazy Outdoors. Like I said, coming up, we're gonna go noodling.
I can't wait. This should be interesting.
Hopefully nobody loses a finger or arm. So.
don't even talk like that.
Well, you damn loggerhead turtle. You just never know.
I'm starting to rethink this.
You're not going to rethink it. You're going to jump right in.
Okay.
My brother will be out there.
All right. Okay. Okay. I'm doing this. Mark my words. I'm doing this. I'm going to give myself a pep talk.
Got it. All right, man. Y'all take it easy,
guys.
And we'll see y'all next time.